We have Atulwasan, former cricketer, and Anumita Roy Chaudhary from the Center for Science and Environment joining us for more on this. Atul, first to you. Every athlete is imbibed with the sportsmanship spirit. Compete at all costs. You may fall, but you pick yourself up and you drag yourself over the finish line. You fight till the last ball, you fight till the bell rings. But are we asking too much of international athletes to expose themselves to hazardous levels of pollution to play?
Well, you know, there are two sides to this issue. Actually, I think it was poor gamesmanship by Sri Lanka. I agree that, you know, it's not perfect conditions. There's a problem we've got to live with. 27 million people are living with this, you know. I mean, there are certain things we have discussed this before, what can be done.
They're not professional
and, you know,
athletes.
I'm sure the way things move in India, eventually we'll get there. But, you know, I understand, you know, but having said that, you know, Sri Lanka, the way they made a big hoo-ha about it when Virat Kohli was batting for 2 days, you know, and then they came out, the same people who were wearing masks when fielding came out to bat without the mask, you know. So it was just because they were so out of the game, they thought they'll make a mess of it. Having said that, I think fast bowlers had to cope with this. And this is why it's called test cricket, you know. You can't get perfect conditions. We play in blistery conditions when we go to Manchester, Leeds with three jumpers, you know. It's not perfect conditions. But we never try to get the game called off, you know. I mean, so I think, and what India did for Sri Lanka during the 90s when the terrorism was there, India helped Sri Lanka to go there. I think this was in poor taste, what the Sri Lankan batsmen did or the team did.
Okay, that's the terrorism angle certainly is a good analogy. Thanks, but Anumita, are we making a hoo-ha over this?
You know, let's look at it a little differently, because green games is a challenge in itself, and we know that there are special vulnerabilities. Athletes are particularly vulnerable to dirty air, but it's something that we have known always, and we cannot deal with it cricket today and marathon tomorrow. Government requires a strategy for it, and something that we know from the Commonwealth Games during 2010, when we were committed to give clean air during the games, and we did it. And based on that, today we should have at least had some standard operating procedure that should kick in quickly enough to deal with this and take a decision when to do the games and how to do the games and how to maintain air quality during the games. But at the same time, we must also keep in mind that right now we are battling emergency and very severe level of pollution. Right now, of course, it's very poor level, but I will also not belittle, because of this, the efforts that are now being made to kick in the first ever emergency plans in Delhi. And let's keep in mind that if you compare this November with the previous November, last November, at least 54% of the days you had severe levels.
Yes.
But this November, it is 41%. Residents of Delhi and NCR, they are struggling, they are battling, and they are trying everything by stopping trucks, to stopping brick kilns to the Badarpur power plant, and it's a battle that's going on. But games, that requires a different focus, a different strategy, and the government will have to now come up with a green game strategy, something that should be rolled quickly enough for all high profile and international events. We know what to do. Everywhere in the world, governments have to make that commitment that during the event you have to give and provide clean air. But what works for the athletes should also work for the residents. It's so
correct.
Whatever we are proposing to do has to go beyond the games.
Yeah. So Atul, but as a professional athlete yourself, would you not agree, does the government, keeping in mind our conditions, need to come up with a green games strategy? Because we saw the same thing at the time of the Delhi marathon, and then we had a sunny weekend and everybody heaved a sigh of relief. But you live here, you're a resident of Gurgaon, your kids have to breathe this air, your parents, your elderly family members have to breathe this air. Is this a wake-up call?
I think it is, and it's been for a few years, you know. What little has been done is piecemeal, is tokenism, you know. You stop the trucks for a few days, you know, and, you know, you have to stop the crop burning, you've got this Badarpur plant, you know, you've got to live with this. I mean, people are, you know, evolving, and, you know, eventually if the world is submerged by water, we'll grow gills, you know. So, I mean, we are the, you know, collateral damage in the middle when humans actually, you know, will find a way to actually cope with this. But till now, everybody's suffering, and we can't find a way. You know, the dirtiest city in the world.
When
and the worst air quality is in a town in Iran called Zabul.
I mean, there's nothing there. There's no traffic there. You know, but these conditions are
out of your hands.
We saw our cricketers speak out. We saw Virat Kohli tweet seriously about this. A lot of our sportsmen were speaking up. Then why are things different today then?
You know, is it for me?
When we saw a horrible bout of pollution post-Diwali, we saw our cricketers speak up. Virat Kohli, for one, spoke out very strongly on Twitter, talking about, you know, I think he mentioned something about not having a peaceful Diwali without crackers. Why are things different now?
Yes. No, they're no different. I think they could have saved a lot of embarrassment by actually moving, but it's impossible, you know, the logistics. You know, it's crazy to move a match, but they should know. I mean, hindsight is perfect vision. They should have known that hosting a match in Delhi in November, December, you are bound to cope with this. So they could have easily bypassed this. So I think you're right. Probably this event will actually, you know, make people realize that they can't hold marathons or a sporting event. Last year, actually, a Ranji Trophy match was shifted. And now we are having, you know, a test match here. And a month ago, you know, it was 900 something, the points, you know. So you knew that this was going to happen unless it rains. And you could have easily avoided this embarrassment.
Okay, so it has been an embarrassment certainly for India on the international scene. We've, I think the FIFA director has also said sports events in the capital should happen pre-Diwali or after February. But Anumita, what's the last word? Is this a wake-up call? What do we need to figure out from this? Again, like I said, we saw the marathon, then we saw sunny weekend and everybody heaved a sigh of relief. The event went ahead and we all pretended things are hunky-dory again. But they're not.
But I think this year, it is a little bit of the difference that we are seeing because the graded response action plan is already underway. And we are hoping that the comprehensive action plan for more sustained longer term action will also come into play right now. But this is certainly a wake up call to say that we just cannot let up the pressure. Now the momentum is building up and we'll have to ensure that there is no slowdown. And this kind of events, these are certainly a wake-up call. It just kind of comes to you as a reminder that we'll have to do it. It's about taking hard decision. There are no, all soft options are over. And that's the reason why we now have to build both policy, political and public support for very hard decision. But we now know what to do and therefore we just have to stay on track. And the emergency action that we are taking right now will have to be implemented with absolute stringency and discipline, but we cannot always be on emergency mode. That's the reason why we are desperately looking forward to the longer term comprehensive action plan that must kick in straight away for more systemic reforms that is needed.
Correct. This is a wake-up call, but are our policymakers listening? Thanks, Atul. Thanks, Anumita. Thank you both for joining us.